In this problem, we're given information about the rate of a reaction in terms of a Lebensfeld plot. We see it has sort of a funny shape, and that's to make the analysis easier in terms of the math. This was previously an exam problem. We have three different reactors, a 20-liter PFR, 15-liter CSTR, and 25-liter CSTR. And we're asked first, what single reactor, if we use only one of these, would result in the largest conversion? And what would be the final conversion for that reactor? Can write down the material balances for CSTRs and PFRs. Because a CSTR operates only in its entire volume, only at the outlet conditions, the required volume to achieve a given conversion is a function only of the exit conditions. And so therefore, for example, if we're going to determine what conversion we could achieve in a 15-liter CSTR, then we can put 15 liters as the volume. Right, and then we can find the value of x that we can multiply x by the experimental value of FA naught times negative RA at the exit in order to get 15 liters. This involves a trial and error procedure, but fortunately, this is a fairly simple process for what's given in the problem statement. I happen to know that if I pick a conversion of 30%, what I can read off the plot is that experimentally, FA naught over the reaction rate is equal to 50. And so 0.3 times 50 liters is equal to 15 liters. And so therefore, we know that the 15-liter CSTR gives us a conversion of 30%. Next, we can consider the 25-liter CSTR. It turns out that if we pick a conversion of 50%, again, we use only the exit conditions, we go over and read off the same reaction rate. Okay, and so we see that we achieve a conversion of 50% in a 25-liter CSTR, which is greater, not surprisingly, than in the smaller CSTR of 15 liters. Now, for a PFR, we have a different material balance expression where the volume of the PFR, the required volume for a given conversion, does not depend just on the exit conditions, but is the integral of all the conditions up to the final conversion. And that corresponds to the area under the curve up to the final conversion. Right, and so it turns out that if we pick a conversion of 30% and we look at the area under this curve, that will be equal to, we can basically break up the evaluation of the area under the curve into a rectangle that's shown here, and then a triangle that's above the rectangle. Okay, and so the rectangle will be 0.3 conversion times the 50 for the height. And so that's the first term we show here. The second term, we again have a height of 50 and a length of 0.2. And since it's a triangle, we take half the base times the height. And so that gives us the 20 liters. And so we see that the 20-liter PFR gives us a conversion of 30%, which is well below that's achieved in the 25-liter CSTR. In part B of the problem, we're asked if you were to use two of the three reactors in series, which two would you use and in which sequence would you use them? We've already seen that if we use either of the CSTRs, it's probably going to make sense to use the 25-liter CSTR. Because it allows us, since it's larger, to achieve a higher conversion than its counterpart. It actually allows us to go all the way to this conversion of 50%, and we notice that there's a discontinuity here, and that beyond this point, what's happening is that the reaction rate decreases with conversion. And for situations where the reaction rate decreases with conversion, it's usually advantageous to use a PFR rather than a CSTR. The reason for that is that, say, we were hypothetically going out to this conversion. All right, then the volume that would be required for a CSTR would be much greater than that required for a PFR. So if we were trying to achieve this extra bit of conversion, because the volume required for a PFR is proportional to the area under the curve, whereas the volume required for a CSTR would be proportional to the area of this entire rectangle, including under the curve. Using a PFR in this region beyond 50% conversion is advantageous, whereas a CSTR is clearly advantageous in this region, where the opposite is true, where the rate actually increases as the conversion increases. All right, in this range, It doesn't matter which we use. Zero order type behavior. By using first the 25 liter CSTR and coming to a conversion of 50%, we utilize a CSTR where it's most advantageous to do so, and then where it doesn't matter. And then after that, we can use our 20 liter PFR. And so our solution to part B of this problem is that we will use the larger CSTR first, then the PFR.